I've been looking for a way out.
Train to get in that shape?
I trained like 5 months, pretty much 4 months really consistently, like two times a day. Because I didn't know anything. I knew about boxing, but I had never really trained for real like that. So I knew I needed to double my time kind of. So I made kind of 8 months and 4 months and really learned.
I started training with Terry and it was 5 months. 5 months, two times a day. I didn't know how to box when I began the process. And Terry's brilliant. I mean, his style and his technique for teaching really is about the specifics and not about strength and not about emotion or anger guiding you. It's about a very specific technique and you learn everything step by step. We spent weeks on my jab and my jab alone, footwork also, all the most sort of frustrating things, you know. But at the same time, the way in which he teaches combinations in particular, they just locked in with me. A lot of times when you work the mitts and stuff, a lot of trainers will pound down on the hands as you know, you punch. And Terry doesn't, he just holds in different positions and over a period of time as he starts to move, you know exactly where to throw angles. So you're throwing angles not because of strength because you're trying to hit something, you're throwing it for the angle itself and the accuracy of the angle. And so I started to understand boxing not just as sort of a brute kind of aggressive sport, but as a science with a specificity that requires only 5 pounds of pressure to knock somebody out.
I trained over the course for 7 months. Three, in fact, maybe even more, because almost 3.5, 4 months before the film started, I was here training with my own trainer. Then when the film trainer arrived, I started training with him and my own trainer.
3 months before we even came to Montreal, and then trained for another 4 or 5 weeks here before the film even started. And at some points, I was training 4 hours a day in the gym. I had two trainers, two separate trainers. I don't know what I was thinking. they have trained their whole lives. There's nothing they want.
Pretty burly there. What's the diet and workout regime?
Yeah, it was brutal. I gained about 40 pounds. So I'm about 20 down from that now. But it was, 5,000 calories a day and just doing whatever I could to pay homage to Chris Kyle.
Yeah, the change, the weight, I mean, one's physical habitation is everything. When you're sick, you changes the way your mental, emotional state, and it's the same way when your body changes physically. So it was quite a dramatic shift for me, the way I walked through life, 35, 40 pounds heavier of muscle, and changed everything.
Your heart, your nerve, and sinew to serve your turn long after it has gone. And there is nothing left within you except the will to say to them, hold on. That's where we at right
condition in there.
I've spent the past
25 years, the past, you know, two-thirds of my life, searching out the best trainers on the planet, the best methods on the planet. I did this completely naturally, no steroids, no human growth hormones. I was not born genetically to put on muscle. I was cursed with long limbs. But somehow I found a way to do it.
I think you're pretty funny, don't you, freak?
Flash, it was just an accident.
My fist breaking your teeth, that's the accident.
Come on, Flash, stop.
I don't want to fight you, Flash.
I wouldn't want to fight me neither.
Kick his ass, man.
I didn't have it easy, and I eliminated all of the excuses, and just know that if I can do it, you can do it. Anything is possible.
But who are you, really?
You'll see soon enough.
God, I hope you're not crazy.
So, tell me a little bit about preparing for this role. I know there were a couple of things I heard. First, that you trained a lot and that you actually kind of like bulked up too much for the part.
Yeah, it was funny because I got the part and immediately started looking at the comic books, and the guy's, you know, 500 pounds or something and looks like Schwarzenegger. And I thought, okay, I'm not going to get to that. So, you know, I have to get bigger. And so it became about eating a lot and training a lot. And they kept saying, yeah, just get
as big
as you can.
I put on a lot of weight for the film, you know. I put up sort of about 20 pounds at one stage, and then that was sort of too far, and we had to sort of strip it back because the costume was too tight in certain areas, and I was getting, you know, pins and needles in my fingers, and so we had to do some adjustments, and I had to strip down a bit. But then it was about sort of maintaining that optimum weight that fit into the costume because it didn't have much give in it. Yeah, it was a whole lot of working out and eating the right foods and sort of, you know, trying to keep on that same level.
Is that real?
Yeah, I wouldn't have spent 6 months in the gym. I read the comic books and noticed the character was 700 kilograms, so that's certainly a little bit of fire.
Were you doing push-ups before you went on air to,
yeah,
to record?
Yeah, there was all sorts of, you know, little dumbbell things, and everyone's standing around looking at you.
Getting,
you know,
the muscle
what
pump.
An idiot.
No, they're not.
are so famous now. Do you feel like you have to keep up with that? So you have to, like, always be in good shape now?
I mean, no, because it kind of just depends on the role. I mean, I don't want to have abs for too much longer. I mean, I've always enjoyed being healthy. I'm a healthy eater. I play sports a lot. But, yeah, I look forward to playing roles that don't require abs or anything like that.
Doesn't he own a shirt?
Hey, beautiful.
Hi.
So you're getting a lot of attention from girls as well. How are you dealing with that? Are you getting used to that now, or?
I don't think you ever really get used to it.
You're looking good. How do you keep that?
How did you do
physique?
This? How did you do this?
Oh, I went to a nutritionist and then I started physically running instead of emotionally running.
Yeah, that's smart. Just get on the treadmill.
And then I do a lot of, like, a friend of mine was like, if you do 100 push-ups a day,
yeah,
you will be in good shape.
That's true.
And I worked my way up, and now I do that every day.
Now there's a dramatically different you.
Right, exactly. I mean, I cut my hair, is what you're talking about.
You cut
about,
your hair,
right?
And it just made you look like you dropped 30 pounds.
Yeah, exactly.
Is that what it is?
I have a really incredible hairstylist. Yeah.
Did you have a secret? Did you do the Seth Rogen diet?
I don't know what Seth did. Rogen, no, I think did. Seth went to this, like, trainer. I went to just a nutritionist.
Ah.
He really helped me understand nutrition.
Yeah, I worked really hard, you know, for 6 months or so. I went to the gym every day and ate so much chicken, really ungodly amounts of chicken. And I gained 12 pounds and, yeah, did a lot of work.
No, that last one sounds weird, but I'm just being honest. Nothing else does it for me the same way. Not even real pussy. And yo, I get plenty of that. Why you think my boys call me the Don? Man.
God.
From last week?
Oh, shit.
What, the blondie in a dress? She was insane, bro. You hit that?
No, I didn't. Fucking alcoholic. I saw you after she left.
Hey, fuck you, Johnny.
I thought you made that happen.
Nah, I threw it to this other end.
That's too much.
Probably like an 8 or 9.
6 or 7.
You shut the fuck.
Uh-huh.
baby. What are you doing? You talking to yourself?
Yo.
Holy man. I'll do it again. Rainbow City.